Welcome back to MacBreak Studio. I'm Mark Spencer, and we have our special guest, Sam Mestman, who's been with us a few times before. Welcome back.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, all the time. It's fun to have you. You're always doing something different.
Well, there's a lot going on. I mean, it's what's nice is there's so much development happening here. Every time I turn around, and I'm like, this is the thing that I've been really wanting forever, and then bam, it's there, you know?
There's either new features in Final Cut to talk about, or there's new plugins to talk about, or in this case, you're going to do something by combining the power of two separate plugins in Final Cut to do something pretty amazing.
So pretty much my two favorite actual video plugins for actual real video work are SliceX and Color Finale. And what Roger Bolton did with the latest release.
So Roger Bolton, who runs Cormel. That produces SliceX and TrackX.
What he did is he put this little special feature in the latest release of SliceX that allows you to track a mask on a Color Finale correction, specifically for Color Finale. And for those of you guys who don't know what Color Finale is, it enables really deep, powerful curves and vector color grading, which I'll show you guys in a second, to allow you far more control over your footage than you would typically have with just the Final Cut 10 color board.
Right, so it's another plugin for Final Cut Pro 10, but it's a color correction plugin.
So for a person who uses DaVinci Resolve a lot, where I'll typically track power windows in Resolve, this allows me to do the exact same thing right in Final Cut 10 without having to do the extra conform step.
Let's show us, because this is exciting.
So basically, the really cool thing about this is ordinarily you have, or used to have, just have SliceX, but if you have Color Finale installed on your machine, when you have SliceX installed, you're gonna see this little SliceX Extras folder. And one of the filters in there is Color Finale with Shape Mask. And what this allows you to do is it takes the regular standard Cormel interface, and it puts a little mask on. And what we're gonna do right now is we're going to track his face. If you notice, he's got a little bit of a ruddy complexion, a little red, and she feels to fit this sort of yellowish scene a little bit more than he does. He feels kind of red in this correction. So what I wanna do is kind of take some of the saturation out of his face and sort of lighten him up. And it's a really subtle correction, which is kind of what I recommend you do.
You want to do a color correction to just his face, so a secondary color correction, and you want to track that so it moves with him.
Exactly.
Which you can do in Final Cut Pro natively, but you need to use keyframes to do it.
And this would be a very long process with those tools.
And so we're going to use the tracking tools in SliceX.
So we're going to use the tracking tools in SliceX combined with the Color Finale tools that come by default. And it's going to be a very simple process, and I'm going to do a larger adjustment before we really dial this in so you see the results. So all that happens is now with this selected, I'm going to Color Finale with Shape Mask. I'm going to open the controls panel for Color Finale. And there's three distinct controls in Color Finale. There's color wheels, there's four actually. We're going to use three of them, curves and the vectors. And I'm going to start with the color wheels, and what I want to do is I just want to pull just a little bit of red out of his face. But I'm going to do that on the mids, and if you notice, it's not quite doing what I want it to do, where I'm making him very red.
Yes.
And so it's a very, very subtle shift. I'm just going to pull just a little bit out, just to remove some of that there. And that's really all I'm going to do. And I'm also going to tighten up his face by going into the blacks here and adding a couple points on the curves on the luminance curve. And if you notice, that's going to really kind of put a little more contrast in there and make him really feel. But what I've then done is, if you notice, because I added this contrast, I've added a little bit, and if I pull, you'll see what this is doing on the curve side.
Yes.
I've now added more red than I wanted to, because the contrast is allowing me to see a little bit more of that red channel. So what I might then do is go into the vectors here, and this is unique to Color Finale, and select the red vector. And now I can tweak just the red channel, which I want to reduce, by clicking in here and just dragging down the red slider, and this is going to change.
So you're adjusting the hue a little bit to shift it away from red?
And now there's still a little too much saturation, so I'm going to go into the saturation and pull that down as well. And then I can adjust the luminosity if I want to do the overall, brightness. And now maybe I'm there, and I'm maybe just going to pull the saturation back a little bit more. And now he's largely matching with significantly better contrast. In fact, he looks better than her now.
So that mask came from Slice X, and then the color correction you're doing with Color Finale. They're working together, and you can feather that mask, I'm assuming, to have some fall off on it.
Yeah, so there's the blur and the mix and, and the blur strength. And we actually don't even need it in this scenario.
Great. Okay.
And if you look, so now this is the, I'll do the before and the after with the image, and then we'll go ahead and track it. So now this is before, and that's after, and it's a subtle adjustment.
Yeah, but you can definitely see it.
And that's really what you want in a typical secondary anyway. You don't want anything that's gonna pop out from the image. You want it to be a very subtle thing.
Yes.
And then, and now, because if you notice, his face sort of moves around here, well, this would not look good at all, just standing there, you know. So what I really wanna do is get back to the frame that I was on, right about there, where his face is, and I can just now track by pushing the forward track button on this. And you're gonna be able to see the circle is gonna sort of move with his face.
So it's analyzing the clip and tracking the motion. Yeah, it's tracking it perfectly.
And I can keep that little subtle adjustment. And this is, you know, and it's the sort of thing that you can do just to target, and this saves endless amounts of time keyframing, because it's also adjusting the shape of the mask too. And this is largely what you would do in DaVinci Resolve.
It's automatically adjusting the shape of the mask?
Yeah, so it's adjusting, it's determining what's happening to that area that you've targeted,
yes,
and then it's going to change the shape as you go, and you can track forwards and backwards. So now I tracked the second half of that mask, but I didn't track the beginning of it. So if you notice, it's still...
It stays still on the first
half. So I would pick the best frame that's most representative of what you're doing, and then you track forward, and you now track back. And now it's going to go backwards in time and track that way.
And it's even modifying the shape of the mask, because it understands the part that's moving.
And exactly, and it's analyzed that
fantastic
image.
Fantastic. So this is something that you mentioned. You can do a DaVinci Resolve, but now this is something you can do by staying right inside of Final Cut Pro by using two plugins together.
And the amount of time that you spend conforming and round-tripping, depending on what you need to do, this really enables a lot of functionality that you wouldn't have had otherwise.
Great. Very, very cool. Awesome, awesome tip. So where can people find out more about what you're into and what you do?
So there's three places. You can go to fcpworks.com. That is where we do workflow and integration. If you're interested in getting involved in what we're doing on the independent film side, that's wemakemovies.org. And if you're interested in group workflow or collaborative workflow, we have a new product called the Share Station, and that is LumaForge.
LumaForge. Okay, you're a busy man.
I'm having a good time.
Great. Excellent. Sam, thank you very much. Thank you for watching MacBreak Studio. I'm Mark from RippleTraining.com, and we'll see you next week right here.